20 years ago, I graduated as an industrial design engineer. It was the time when the internet was taking on, and you could feel that a revolution was happening. This was going to be big, they said, but nobody could exactly tell you where we were going. But everybody wanted a piece of the pie. People started to explore the possibilities of this new technology, even myself. And one day, I came across a device called MindDrive. The first computer product operated by human thought, they said. Incredible, right? Well, honestly, I didn't believe it. I couldn't believe that a device connected to your finger would be able to measure brain signals. But a little seed was planted, waiting for the right situation to grow. In 2000, I quit my job as a design engineer to start working as a SolidWorks support engineer. And in that period, I started to learn more about programming. I knew that a lot was possible, but I didn't know exactly what or how. So I decided to open that door and explore the possibilities that lay behind. And in that period, this little seed came back into my mind. And in 2013, when I was searching the internet, I came across a device called the Emotive Epoch Headset. It was a device that you could wear on your head that was able to measure your brain signals. And on their website, they had an example on how to rotate a little block by thinking about rotation. And I immediately knew that this was what I'd been waiting for. Control your computer by thought. I was wondering if I could use the device to control SolidWorks. So I decided to buy one. I tried it and started working on an application to connect the device to SolidWorks. While the application was running, the headset showed a few weaknesses. But fortunately, the headset company, Emotive, started a Kickstarter campaign to raise funds to develop a new version of the headset. So I decided to put some money in, and in 2015, I received a new version of the headset. It looked beautifully, and I couldn't wait to get my hands on it to get it working. I'm now going to give you a short demonstration to tell you how it works. The first step is you have to create a user profile so the device learns to recognize your brain signals. This is an application that comes with the headset. And in this application, there's like a training center for mental commands. I can select a profile. And now when I think about rotation, but that's only creating the profile. The second step is to pick up the signal by an application that I created. So with this one as well, I have to connect to the headset, select the user profile again, and now when I think about rotation, you see, nothing happens. On the left corner, you can see that the mental command is picked up, but it is not mapped to an action in SolidWorks. So that's the third step I have to do. In this case, for example, I can use rotating to the left to, for example, rotating to the left. And now, when I start thinking about a left rotation, voilà. I can also map this to other actions. In this example, I'm going to create a boss extrude, for example. I select a face and think about a left rotation. And there it is. You just witnessed for the first time the creation of 3D geometry by thought. Yes, there are still a few weaknesses. But if we look at technologies like deep learning and artificial intelligence, they are relatively new and rapidly evolving. They may be of great value when it comes to creating the user profile and distinguishing the signals. And maybe one day we won't need people anymore to create a profile. But will 3D CAD be the first place where we find devices like these? I don't think so. I think we will first see them in healthcare. Philips, for example, is already experiencing to help patients communicate after they lost the ability to talk. This device will also be a great benefit for people with reduced mobility or with a locked-in syndrome. This device will also introduce a new interface for gaming and augmented reality, virtual reality, and allow people to navigate through a 3D world. People already use this device to control drones. And if we take that a few steps further, you can think of pilots controlling their plane. This will start with simple tasks, but as it becomes more developed, the tasks can be more difficult. In the introduction of my presentation, I talked about the beginning of the internet. Back then, we didn't know where we were going. People were wondering why you would need something like a website. And look at where we are today. The internet is everywhere. We went from websites to web shops, social media, online gaming, cloud computing, cryptocurrencies, and there's lots to come. Today, we open the door to a whole new world, and we don't know what lays behind. Tomorrow, the headset may even disappear, making the mind more powerful than ever. The mind is like a parachute. It only functions when it's open. Are you ready to jump?